Want to learn engineering and science? Well, you've tuned in to the right channel. Hit subscribe and press the bell icon and never miss an update from us.
Hey guys, what's up? This is your friend and tutor Manas, and today we're going to be talking about projection of planes. Well, first of all, let me tell you what exactly plane means, or rather what is the definition of a plane. It goes like this: a flat surface with negligible thickness can be referred to as a plane. Okay, so this over here is a flat surface. You can see this having negligible thickness, so this can be referred to as a plane. That's it. Now, as far as the problems based on projection of planes is concerned, it basically has three steps: step one, step two, step three. When you speak of step one, you have the initial assumption. Yes, I'm right, initial assumption. Then you have step two, in which you have to go for surface inclination. Now, that surface inclination could either happen with the horizontal plane, it could happen with the vertical plane also, all right? And then in final step three, you have to go for edge inclination. Now, the most important step in all the three steps that I've just explained to you right now is step number one, in which we have to make the initial assumption, and your initial assumption has to be absolutely spot on. Now, the initial assumption of step one is completely dependent on step two's condition and step three's condition, okay? And I'll explain you how you need to take that initial assumption. All right, so to begin with, we have divided this into two parts: surface inclined to HP, surface inclined to VP, and the object that I'm going to be considering is this pentagonal plane. All right, so the first case is surface inclined to HP. It's like this. Now, you guys are watching this from the front, okay? Surface inclined to HP. All right, so you can see this angle theta that the surface makes with the horizontal plane, okay? So what shall be the initial assumption? This. We are initially going to assume that the entire surface will be resting on to the horizontal plane. And then we just got to think, from where can we see the true shape of this surface? Well, obviously, the answer is from the top. And therefore, you have to begin by making the top view first. Okay, so you can keep the pentagon like this, okay, like this, whichever way, it's absolutely correct. But make sure that the entire pentagon in itself is resting with, is resting onto the horizontal plane. That's it. Okay, so for simplicity, I'm going to be making two types of pentagons. One is going to be what I call the horizontal pentagon. This is what I call the horizontal pentagon, and this is what I call the vertical pentagon. Okay, fine. All right, now let me add one more condition to this. Surface is inclined to HP. Okay, so these two cases are possible. If you draw this, this is also correct. If you draw this, this is also correct. But what if I write along with this edge inclined to VP? Now there is a confusion whether to choose option one or option two. Okay, now guys, remember this: whenever edge is inclined to VP, now edge inclination is something that is going to happen in step number three. And whenever edge is inclined to either HP or VP, always make sure that in step number one, that edge has to be kept perpendicular to the XY line. Okay, right now we have made this top view, and in this top view, this edge over here is perpendicular to XY. Whereas if you consider this, this is not inclined, okay, or rather not perpendicular. This is also not perpendicular. This is not perpendicular. This is also not perpendicular to XY. So therefore, we are rejecting option two and we are accepting option one. Alright, so if in the description only this much is given, surface is inclined to HP, both the options are absolutely correct. Okay, and if in the description there is some more addition in the form of edge inclined to VP also, then in that case you have to reject option 2 and you have to go for option 1. That's it. Okay, so let me rub this and you guys can note this down. Pause the video and note whatever I have said till now. Okay, let me rub this. Alright. Now, we're going to talk about this second part, where the surface is inclined to VP. Alright, so it's something like this. Watch this carefully. This is the plane, pentagonal plane, surface inclined to VP. This is the inclination phi that the surface is making with the vertical plane. Alright, and this angle can only be seen from the top. Okay, so our initial assumption is going to be like this. We are going to assume that the entire surface is resting on the vertical plane, and then you just got to think, from where can you see the true shape of this surface? Well, the answer is pretty obvious. It's from the front, and Therefore, you have to begin by making the front view first. So you can make the front view like this, okay, sort of a horizontal pentagon. You can make the front view like this also. This is what I call a vertical pentagon. Okay, fine. Now let me add something. Plus edge incline to HP. Now if there is this condition also along with this one, what shall be the correct option? Whether option 1 is correct or option 2. This is something that you need to work out. And as far as edge inclination is concerned, it actually happens in step number 3. So what kind of an impact is this edge inclination gonna have in step number 1? That is something that we're gonna be working out. Again, you have two options, option 1 and option 2. Which one of these options is correct? Okay, now if you watch carefully, here the edge is working out perpendicular to XY. That's why this is the correct option and this is the incorrect option. Alright, so remember this, whenever edge is inclined to either to HP or VP, that is going to happen in step number 3. Always try to make sure that in step number 1, that edge shall be kept perpendicular to XY. So guys, now I'm sure you must have got a good idea as to how the initial position or the initial assumption is made. Okay, if you've got any doubts or queries, do write them down in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to answer them. And do share and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and also let your friends know about this channel so that they can also benefit. Bye bye and take care.